I have a special connection to America's oil producers from my first energy trip to visit a rig in Texas, to a coal mine in Kentucky, seeing a way to make cleaner coal, and at Steel City, that was the Keystone Hub that never happened. I've been to all these towns. I've seen firsthand what happens when those jobs are lost. And to discuss it, let's bring in North Dakota Republican Senator Kevin Cramer, a member of the Senate Environment and Public Works Committee. Senator, great to see you this evening. What I didn't have was pictures of my trips to the Bakken. I took many of those. I was up at the Dakota Access Pipeline as well. It was wonderful to see the industry booming there, and the Bakken really was part of sort of the energy revolution and our future. Now, drilling rigs there down to 34 from 57 in 2019. Mm-hmm. Tell me about it.
Yeah, no, great point, because that really gets to the jobs issue. Watching your previous segment, it's sort of heartbreaking to, well, it's not sort of, it's heartbreaking to see the men and women who were working once and now, and by the way, working really good jobs. These clean energy jobs that the Biden administration is promising don't pay as much. They don't pay as much, frankly, as the oil and gas jobs do. So, but the reflection of you know 34 rigs versus 57 rigs is really seen, I think, in the sales tax numbers. It gets right to the bottom line. So take a county like McKenzie County, Watford City, North Dakota, heart of the Bakken, a lot of federal lands, home to Theodore Roosevelt National Park's North Unit. Their sales tax revenue is down 44%.
Yeah.
For, you know, that means the hardware store, obviously the restaurants, the bars, the grocery stores, all of the retailers. That's a massive drop in revenue at the local small business level. And so it's not just a matter of the oil workers, which is bad enough, which is awful, but that's the entire value chain, including the small retailers.
Yeah, and that's the point I was trying to make in Texas as well, and the impact on the local economy there and the folks who live on the ground. Let me ask you this, because we were having a conversation about pipelines as well, one of the most safe and efficient ways to transport oil. How is it that we've got an infrastructure bill on the table for over $1 trillion? It is a bipartisan bill, and we're not looking to invest in our pipeline infrastructure.
Well, there's actually some provision in there for that. There's some regulatory relief for gas gathering lines, which, by the way, you know, in as we talk about the Biden administration's agenda, they just announced this methane rule, which is designed basically to make it even more difficult for small producers, particularly existing wells, even go after the flaring of natural gas, which is not a waste product. Natural gas, we ought to be building more lines to capture that gas, then it's a valuable commodity. We actually had some provisions in the infrastructure package that provide some regulatory relief for anything that helps reduce that flaring and capture more of that natural gas and that methane. So there's sort of a conflict even of visions and of policies that the Biden administration is pushing that make zero sense. Jackie, the reality is, and I love the pipeline worker that you had on, because he pointed to the fact that pipelines and frankly all of production in the United States of America of natural gas and oil and other fossils is done cleaner and greener here than anywhere else in the world. So this transfer of 2 million barrels a day or 2.5 million barrels a day of production from the federal lands of the United States to Vladimir Putin and Iran and Saudi Arabia, OPEC Plus, is bad on every level. Bad on every
Thank you.
Single level.
Thank you for bringing up that point, because it's very important. Part of the shale revolution and part of the fracking technology that we unlocked so much resources under the ground was the fact that we were able to do it more efficiently and in a safer way. That's the innovation that comes out of American technology. That's the innovation that this administration wants to stifle. Senator Kevin Cramer, thank you so much. Good to see you.
Always a pleasure. Good to see you, Jackie. Thank you.